In this video, we will understand what statistical arbitrage means, and the steps involved in implementing statistical arbitrage strategies. Statistical arbitrage, or Stat Arb, is based on the statistical mispricing of one or more assets compared to the expected value of these assets. In simpler words, if the quantitative analysis using current and historical market data suggests that prices are off from expected value, then it provides an arbitrage opportunity. This will be detailed out further in the video. The birth of Stat Arb can be dated back to the mid-1980s. A small group of researchers working at Morgan Stanley created a strategy to buy and sell stocks in a pair. This strategy quickly earned a reputation and given the name pairs trading. By the early 1990s, analysis techniques became more sophisticated and models deployed were more tech-savvy. This is when the term statistical arbitrage was first used. Stat Arb suggests to take positions against the general norms of the market, short the overperforming asset, go long the underperforming one. We will now discuss the basic steps in implementing a Stat Arb strategy on a universe of stocks. We start with a universal set of stocks. Consider all the stocks being traded on the exchange. We filter down to a subset. Filter this universal set of stocks into a subset by carefully matching them by region and sector. Co-integrated stocks are identified to take advantage of the temporary widening of spread. We will discuss co-integration in detail in the next section. Then rank the subset. Each stock in the subset is then given a rank generally using the mean reversion principle. According to the mean reversion principle, it is expected that individual assets, or their linear combination, tend to move around the mean. Hence it is expected that underperforming stocks will rise, and overperforming ones will fall. Although the scoring formula varies depending on which financial parameters are considered for ranking the stocks, generally underperforming stocks will receive higher scores, and outperforming stocks receive lower scores. The higher scored stocks are to be held long, whereas lower scored stocks are to be shorted. Take positions. Long the top X percent and short the bottom X percent of the ranked subset. Based on the risk-taking capacity of the system, the numbers X and Y will be decided. We continue to rebalance the portfolio. Rebalancing involves periodically buying and selling assets in a portfolio to maintain an original desired level of allocation. Rebalancing can have a large impact on the portfolio in terms of trading costs and taxation. The optimal frequency for rebalancing depends on the assets in the portfolio, and must be carefully evaluated to minimize risks. To recap, the primary steps involved in a Stat Arb strategy are: first, start with a universal set of stocks. Second, filter down to a subset. Third, rank the stocks within the subset. Fourth, take positions by going long on higher ranked and shorting the lower ranked stocks. Fifth, rebalance the portfolio as required. That's all to show you in this video. In the upcoming unit, you will learn different types of statistical arbitrage strategies.